In those days, I was younger, stronger. I was physically fit, and I worked alone. This particular scumbag was my white whale for all of 6 months. He called himself Bulletfoot. He was not a fast man for obvious reasons.
Got nowhere left to live, Bulletfoot.
This isn't over.
Who are you working for?
That's none of your concern, Jorge Sanchez.
I lock up pigs like you on a regular basis. It's my job to get to the top of the food chain. Now I'll ask you once again. Who do you work for?
So do you really think he did it all by himself?
Yeah. That's Jorge Sanchez.
Let's dance in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. For the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not?
Hey, dude, look, there's Sanchez over here. Hey, Sanchez, Brent wants to ask you a question over here.
What is it? We just wanted to know how you did it. All by yourself?
I snuck up on him when he least expected it. And then I grabbed with my bare hands. Simple as that.
Hey, Sanchez.
Excuse me, gentlemen.
So, what have we got?
Quadruple homicide.
This job gets more grim every day. And what weapon did he use?
Grim is an understatement. This guy chokes people. No weapons besides his own two hands.
Well, and why do the victims have hand marks on their necks?
That's this guy's mark, I guess. He likes to coat his hands in chalk and then strangle his victims to death.
Oh, well, he's just asking to get caught. And did you run a fingerprint analysis?
Well, we tried and then nothing came up. He's practically invisible.
Well, not if I'm on the case. And I'll start working on it right away.
Hey, Jorge. Hey, they're gonna pair you up with a new guy.
Excuse me?
Like, I know you wouldn't like the idea, but his name's Tom Brooks. He's a young guy. He's a transfer from New York.
New York. Well, you know, New York is very different from Leroy, Mississippi.
Well, the commissioner thinks you're going to need some help on this one. This is not going to be an easy case.
Yo, especially with this new dead weight riding on my back.
You don't shoot the messenger, all right? You take that up with the commish.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I'm sorry, Dan.
Look, we both know that you work alone, but maybe you're going to need more than one brain to catch this strangler guy.
Yeah, well, we'll see.
There you go. A little razzle-dazzle.
What about this?
Try not to pop anything. Oh, beautiful, Richard. Beautiful. As long as you don't hurt yourself. Right. Move on. Oh, man. You are working it, boy. I see beauty in you, son. A little bit of the rear. How about a little more rear? Right. Oh, man. All right. On the count of three, I just want you to bust out whatever feels natural. We're gonna make some magic together. You got it?
Got it.
All right. One, two, three. Bam! 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 All right, that's a little too much. Let's reel it back in. Right, okay. Right, we're back on track now. I hear you. Beautiful. Richard, I think these are gonna turn out wonderful.
Well, all thanks to Samuel Grady, the best photographer in town.
Get out of here. No, seriously, get out of here. I got some stuff to do.
All right, thanks again. So how'd it go?
Great.
I think Leroy Monkley is going to look awesome with this guy on the cover.
All right.
Hey, this is a real job you know. Just because you were some hotshot detective in New York doesn't mean that your big brother doesn't have any talent.
I'm proud of you. I'm just ready for you to get off my couch.
Just give it time, man.
All right. I got to get going. I got to go to work.
Sanchez, you got a minute? Yes, come in.
Nice day out there today.
I agree that it is a nice day.
I think I may take the kids out to the pool this afternoon. You doing all right, Sanchez?
With all due respect, sir, don't play dumb with me. You know I work alone, and now you're making me babysit this detective while I do my work. You know what you've done.
Now you listen to me, amigo. I'm doing what's in your best interest. This isn't another bullet foot. This guy's dangerous. Do you know what they're calling him? The Leroy Strangler. You don't just get a name like that by chance. You need backup. Otherwise, you're gonna get yourself killed.
I've never needed backup once in my life, and I do not need it now. You can tell that little detective to go back where he came from. I'll be fine all by myself.
Am I interrupting anything?
Nothing at all. Who have you got with you, Dan?
Commissioner, this is Tom Brooks. He's the transfer from New York. Tom, this is the commissioner.
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
You too, son. Tom, this is Jorge Sanchez. You two will be working together.
Nice to meet you.
I'll leave you two to get acquainted.
So,
How long have you been?
Let me get one thing straight. I do not work with a partner. I don't believe in it.
Look, I'm just following orders. They said you needed help on this one.
Come with me.
Yes, sir. How does one guy strangle four people all by himself?
Well, that's what we're trying to figure out. Either there's more than one strangler, or this man has got the fastest hands in town.
What was the time?
We're estimating around 2 a.m. What?
All at 2 a.m.?
Give or take an hour. When we got here, these poor muchachos were already deceased. And they must have been going home after a night on the town.
But judging by the pictures, they don't look like people that would hang out with each other.
What do you mean?
I mean, what I'm saying is, I don't think he strangled them all here, at the same time.
And what does that mean?
It means this is where he dumped them off. All of these people were separately selected. And he strangled them all at separate locations. He just wants us to think that he strangled them all here.
So where did he strangle them, In the middle of the street?
No, I'm just thinking that it's possible that he...
Why don't you think before you speak? Let's go back to the station. There's nothing new to be found here.
With all due respect, sir, I think this is a possibility we should look into. I mean, what if he was on the move when he went on the strangling spree?
Tom, you're young. You have a wild imagination. One man cannot move four bodies all by himself without being noticed.
But he did all this in the dark?
Well, if it makes you happy, we'll take a look at that possibility.
Thank you.
Do you like the hand on the chin?
Well, I think you'd look all right without it, but it is totally up to you, sir.
Let's get a few more of these. That's good. Well, what do you think? Do you think my wife will be satisfied?
100%, sir. There is not a doubt in my mind. She's gonna love these.
Well, how much do I owe you?
No. You put that away right now, sir. It is on the house.
I can live with that one.
Woo!
Yeah!
Oh!
Yes!
Woo!
Grady!
Grady, man.
Grady! Save me that money! Boom! Bob! Whoa!
What did you think was gonna happen when you were taking pictures, man?
Boom! If you'll excuse me, Mr. Grady.
Oh, it's no problem, Commish. I'll have these to you in about 3 to 5 business days.
Fantastic.
Gentlemen. Any news?
Brooks has something to say.
Right. Upon visiting the crime scene, it appeared that each victim was unique. I don't think that the strangler strangled all of the victims at the same time. I think he strangled them on different occasions and dumped the victims off at that particular location. I know it might seem improbable, but I honestly believe that's how he does it.
So, you're suggesting that this strangler decided to rub his hands in some chalk and finds a victim, possibly an innocent bystander, someone out for a late night jog, and one by one,
He reached for their necks and tightly clasped his chalky right hands around each one of them and strangled them to death.
Yes, that's what I'm suggesting.
Eventually, he had a tight enough grip that each victim was running out of oxygen. I'm sure it was horrifying.
As much as I enjoy this, Commissioner, I think that that is enough. Tom, why don't you come with me to my office?
Okay.
Sorry. Sometimes I just get a little wrapped up in my thoughts.
What was that all about?
He does that sometimes.
What? Kills people?
No, he just goes off on tangents. He likes to reenact the crime scenes. Almost killed Dan a few years ago.
That's not good.
Yeah, he even loaded the gun. It was a good thing I was there. Probably would have killed Dan.
Well, thanks for stepping in and saving my neck.
Literally. Hello. Yes. Yes, I understand.
Yeah, we'll be there right away.
What is it?
Another victim.
Where?
In some woods on some private property not far from here.
We need to get going.
This was the Strangler's doing.
Yeah, but why does he do that to all the victims?
He's messed up in the head.
Obviously.
He waits to put on the chalk.
What do you mean?
Well, this man, he has no chalk on his clothes, which must mean the Strangler waits to put on the chalk before strangling his victim to death.
I think you're right.
We need to alert any local store that is selling chalk, and we need to find out where this man is getting chalk from. Vamos!
Can you drop me off at Samuel's on the way to work?
Sure. Did he say he was done with the photos?
Yeah. I mean, I guess. I don't see why it wouldn't be. I've called him 3 times since I saw him a few days ago.
Did he call you back?
No. Probably because he's been busy with the pictures.
Maybe you should wait before you show up at his door.
Nah, he'll be cool with it.
He's probably really busy, Richard. I don't think you should go.
Well, how about you just drop me off near his house?
Nope.
Come on, Tom.
You need to be patient.
Don't tell me about being patient. I'm the one staying on the couch all day.
Yeah, well, being intrusive isn't gonna help you. It's just gonna make him think that you're annoying.
You're obtrusive.
Not what I said.
Whatever, dude. You go do whatever it is you and your police friends do. I'm sure it's way more fun than staying on the couch all day.
There's nothing fun about what I do. It's taxing. You can walk anywhere you want. I gave you a key.
Maybe I will go for a walk.
Good. Go get some exercise.
Maybe I will.
You should.
I will.
Okay.
I might.
I'll see you later.
Okay, bye.
Thank you.
Well, hey, Sam. Sam. Hey. Hey.
Well, hey, Richard.
Oh, what are you doing here?
Oh, I was just in the neighborhood. Do you need help with that bucket?
Oh, no. It's fine.
No, I got it.
All right, then.
So is this a bunch of photography equipment? Pretty heavy.
Yeah, it is. Bunch of lamps and light reflectors and stuff.
You know, you're the real deal.
You mean that?
Absolutely, man. When you took my pictures the other day, I just felt like I was in the hands of a professional.
Well, you know, they do say you have to have delicate hands to be a professional.
So do you know when those pictures will be ready?
Well, I was working on them this morning, so it shouldn't be too much longer.
You said one's going to be on the cover of Leroy Monthly?
Now, Richard, I've told you this. It depends on whether the picture actually pertains to a certain feature in the magazine.
So they're going
to
write an entire article about me?
Now, maybe.
I can just see it now. Local male model has what it takes to become a fully blown celebrity.
Now, Richard, you know, as I was saying, there's nothing really guaranteed.
My jawline's gonna look so good.
Richard!
My bad. I'm sorry. So, what are all these for?
Well, I already told you. Photography.
Okay. Thanks.
Goodbye.
Oh, hey. When can I have those pictures back?
I'll get them to you when I can. I'll leave them by the front door.
Okay. Front door. My man. See ya.
Guy looked at me funny the other day, so I punched him in the face.
Oh yeah, that sounds awesome, man.
I'm with the Leroy Police Department. You guys know anything about the Leroy Strangler?
You're on the wrong side of town, Precious.
Hey, dude. Cruising for a bruising.
Kick me in the face!
You wanna play games?
Yeah.
him, okay?
I think you're a real tough guy.
How much longer are we gonna keep this up?
We just have to give it time, Tom. Something is going to come up eventually. We just have to keep looking.
I just don't think interrogating 7-year-olds is gonna get us anywhere.
Well, do you have a better idea? I didn't think so.
Oh. Hey, Richard. I see you went for a walk.
Yep.
What's the...
Oh, all this? I was at Samuel Grady's a while ago.
I was walking by Samuel's house and I saw him.
Hey!
I ran up to him and he gave me a sweet high five.
You are the best dadgum male model I ever knew.
I'm happy to be friends with you.
Thank you, Richard. Say, you mind giving me a hand with these here boxes?
Well, I've got places to be. But I'll make time for you.
You dropped my stuff, but that's all right. We're still good friends.
Which brings us to now.
So it was Samuel's chalk.
I mean, yeah.
All right, well, that's enough for me. Well,
Tom, wait. Even if it is him, we don't have a warrant.
Wait, what are you saying?
Your friend Samuel Grady might be a murderer.
No way. Samuel wouldn't kill anybody.
Sometimes the people closest to you are the ones you know the least.
Whatever. My friend wouldn't do that.
So, how do we get a warrant?
I know someone who will squeal.
Hey, what is this? Hey, you better read the Constitution, because I got rights, you know.
Shut up and sit down.
Samuel Grady.
Yeah, what about him?
Tell me what you know.
I don't know nothing.
Okay.
Oh, you gonna play a little good cop, bad cop?
Not exactly.
Oh, God. What the heck? Who is Samuel Grady?
I don't know.
So who is the Leroy Strangler?
I ain't never gonna tell you.
You can make this easy on yourself and just tell us, or Jorge can keep beating you to a pulp. Your choice.
You calling me a rat?
Of course not. That would be too much of a compliment for someone like you.
I see how it is. Go on ahead, slug me.
You want to tell me what you know?
Samuel's crazy. He gets kicks off of choking people to death. Who is the Leroy Strangler? Say it!
Samuel Grady's the Strangler. Got it.
I'll take this to Intel and get the wheels moving on the warrant.
All right, we might be in for a long night, so I will wait.
Champs, got your warrant.
We need to get a move on. Come on, let's go.
Twelve hours of searching and not a single piece of chalk in the entire apartment.
I got someone on the line I think you are talking.
Hello, this is Detective Sanchez.
Hello, Jorge Sanchez.
Who is this?
You know who I am. I'm your white whale.
Samuel Grady.
Oh, that's not who I am to you and your colleagues. No, I believe I've been coined as the Leroy Strangler.
You know it's over, Grady.
I wouldn't speak so soon if I was you. I have something you want. Or rather, something your partner wants.
What have you done?
Oh, just a little debasing of a wildly self-absorbed male model. It didn't take much to lure him. He's so gullible, you know.
Where is he?
I'll tell you when I see you. I promise he won't be harmed.
Tell me where you are.
I'm certainly not in my home. But y'all already knew that. If you want to find me, come to the burnt forest near the city limits tonight at 7:30 sharp. Oh, and bring no one except your partner, Mr. Brooks.
What about Richard?
I can't tell you that now. It would ruin the surprise. I'll see you soon, Jorge.
What happened?
He's got your brother.
Well, we can't just stand here. We gotta go.
Jorge, where did he say to meet?
City limits, where that fire happened last year. He told me to bring no one with me but Tom.
We'll be close by.
What about Richard?
We're gonna do everything we can to get him to safety.
Well, if it ain't old Sanchez and his little servant boy, Brooks. When's the last time you heard from your brother, Brooks? How's he doing?
Where's Richard?
Easy, boy. He's in a house about 6 miles from here. I tied him up.
Where?
Is that really what you thought was gonna happen? Yeah, why don't I just take you to where he is, you know? Untie him, send y'all on your merry way. I'll ride off into the sunset, tip my hat to you. Good day for everyone. Is that really what you thought was gonna happen?
Get to the point.
This ain't about a simple exchange of information, no. See, this is about a choice. You, little baby Brooks. Now, your brother Richard told me all about you, how you're so noble. You don't ever seem to do nothing wrong. You stand for something. See, not too many people stand for something no more. You're a rare bird, Tom Brooks. And that is exactly why I'm going to break you.
You're all talk, Grady. Tell us what Richard is.
Now here are your choices, baby Brooks. See, Richard is in an abandoned house, 341 Glendale Road. Now the house is rigged with explosives set to go off in about 10 minutes. Now you can run, try to save your brother, or you can save your partner. Think fast.
Hey, it's gonna be okay.
Tom. We're gonna take you to the hospital, okay?
Tom.
I know it hurts, I know. Come on,
Tom.
You can make it through this.
Tom!
What?
Praise Jesus. It hit the metal many years ago. I won Taekwondo competition. He saw the titanium. You go and help your brother. I'll chase him down.
Okay.
Thank you. You need anything?
No, I'm all right.
Are you sure? You gotta tell him what happened.
No, I mean, I'm good. You saw what happened. You can tell him. I really don't want to. Let me just go for a walk.
Okay. I'll see you later. Hey, Commissioner.
Hey, son. Everything all right?
I guess. Jorge! What happened?
Thank you, Tom.
What for?
Thank you for being my amigo.
Yeah, always.
Now go back to the police station. It's safer there. I'm going to talk to Commissioner.
Did you save the day?
Looks like you've been rolling in the mud like a pig.
Dan, I'm sorry.
For what?
Brady.
Yeah, no, we got him.
How? Hey, he was on someone's private property. Our search party got there before Grady could get away. You're good.
You're all right.
We got him. Good work.
So how's Tina doing?
Never quite said.